Hi everybody, I'm Kirsten Meakin from Naio Nails. In this video, I'm going to show you how to do, what would we call it?
It's like ink blot test.
Ink blot test. So like when you go to the shrink or the psychiatrist and they show you a picture and they say, what do you see? One of them. I'm sure there's an official name for it.
Ink blot test.
Is that what it is? Just ink blot test.
No, there isn't nothing near about what it is.
I don't know what it is.
Comment below.
Yeah. Right, so sometimes when we plan designs and everything like that, you can think and think and think of new stuff, but sometimes new designs just happen by accident. So we did this tutorial. I got the backing paper that had the black and white on, and I just folded it in half and just squished it. And then I opened it up and I was like, ooh, like that. So me and Adam were just chatting and I just shoved it in the lamp. Oh, and now I stuck it all together. And I shoved it in the lamp and then I just took it off.
You're struggling there.
Yeah, it wasn't stuck together like this when I took it off. And I was like, oh my God, I really like that.
Oh my God.
Oh my God. Oh my golly gosh. So I'm going to do some little ones on a nail and then... So you'll need some backing paper from a form. So all you literally do is peel off the sticker like that. You're not going to use the matte side. You're going to use the shiny side where the sculpting form was stuck. That is very important. We're going to coat this nail with two coats of... Okay. So we're going to do two coats of this. It's going to give us a subtle background, and that's what I want. I just want to work with a little bit of shimmer that doesn't take away from the main attraction, which is the ink blot design. Right, so you're going to use, obviously, black and white. So we've got Snow White, and we have... Serious black. So I want a design that's going to fit onto this nail. So we're going to start with the white, will be in the middle. So what you need to look at is once you put it on, you're going to fold it over and it's going to spread. Yeah. So you're going to start with the white in the middle. Yeah. And then all you need to do is put the black next to it, and then we're going to fold where that white finishes. And then we're going to press, open it out. Oh, look, it looks like an angel. However, I don't think that'll come off in one piece. Because I look at it, there's too much of a gap. But that is amazing. Right, let's add a bit more white. And a bit more black next to it.
Isn't that going to push it out and make it
wider? It will make it wider, yeah. But we've got to connect it somehow. We can cut it. I like this bit, it's pretty exciting, this bit. Oh my God, now it looks like a vajaja.
It looks like a muscly chicken.
I think it looks like a skull. Like a ram's skull.
Yeah, it does.
Oh, put that into the lamp. I'm loving that. That is amazing. Right, so here we have the design. Now this is the tricky part, because we're going to take this off the backing paper. I think we should start here, if you look at that. So it will be delicate. Now what we need to do is, oh my god, this is amazing. I'm going to stick it on with Urban Graffiti top coat. I suppose you could use a bit of brush on glue, but I want it to be quite sealed. And I want to have time to slide it around. If you did use glue, it wouldn't, you know, you wouldn't have much time at all, really, to play with it. So we're going to stick that on.
Should I have, like, little minions who make these?
Make them all ready to put on. They like decals, aren't they, really?
Yeah, I suppose
they so. Like decals, so yeah, you could pre-make them, so you can just pick them up and, you know, put them into people's nails. So once you're happy with your positioning, you're going to pop that into the lamp. Right, so what we're going to do now is we're going to take off this excess. That's easily done by just filing it. Going to do now is do one coat of clear. This is the Urban Graffiti top coat. You better put in lots of thin layers of this on rather than really thick ones. Don't like get carried away thinking, oh, I'm just going to put loads on and encapsulate the whole thing. You're better doing thin coats. Pop that into the lamp. So when you've applied a couple of coats, what I'm going to do now is just smooth over the top to make it more smooth, and then we'll go in with a final top coat. Boom shakalaka. Does that look like a skull? I think it does. I love it. That's pretty cool. So what I'm going to do now, because I like playing around and stuff, and I like bringing you along with my experience of playing with things, nail related. I've just done some little ones on here. Oh, this looks like a... Oh.
I can't see it.
TIE fighter. X-Wing.
You're doing your Star Wars stuff again.
So, yeah. Oh, I don't know if this is going to come off in one. Look at that. What actually I'm going to do is I'm going to just use that part. I like that bit. And I'm going to do like a random kind of pattern. So these ones are folded in half. These are, that one's in half, and then them two are just squished over. So you can come up with any kind of thing. I like these. They kind of look like petals in a way. What I'm going to do is just arrange them however I want them.
Thank you.
That looks pretty cool.
I think that's cool. I've like overlaid it as well. So what I've done is I've picked pieces that I like, and I've even overlapped them as well and kind of made this crazy pattern. It looks pretty cool. I'm gonna do the same with the top coat with this one as well. So there you are. This is obviously the first one we did, which is a big one, which I really like. And then there's this one. And what I did is I just layered it all and overlapped. And I really like it as well. I don't know which one's my favourite. Comment below. I want you to know, I want you to tell me if the first one is your favourite. This is the first one. I do think it looks like a ram skull.
It does. It's got a skull like a...
Yeah, I want you to tell me what you think it looks like.
Yeah, we'll see how insane people are, because that's the thing, isn't it? Is it?
Is it?
Test how your sanity is, or... I know Batman saw bats in one of the Batman films, which would make sense.
Well, yes, it would make sense. That would. Or do you prefer number two? And is there anything you see in that? And what's it called again?
Rorschach.
Rorschach test. Let's see what you come up with the Rorschach test nail designs I've created. I think that was really cool though. It's something really easy to do. You don't really need any kind of, you know, artistic skills really. It's just laying it down, giving it a squish, opening it up, curing it, peeling it off, bang on the nail, and you're done. So there you are, guys. Hope you've enjoyed this video. Don't forget to check us out on Facebook and Instagram. And also give us a thumbs up and subscribe. And I'll see you guys in the next video. Bye-bye. Thanks for watching.